We all have happy memories of our childhoods, but what if I told you some of those are based on total lies? Whether it's a book, a film, or a TV show you loved as a kid. Or maybe just a general fact about your childhood you've always thought back on. A lot of these are total lies and farces, and there are some very dark secrets behind things which made your childhood what it was. I'm Charlie, and today we're going to look at facts that will ruin your childhood. Strap in, because we're going on a nostalgia trip. But first, subscribe and press the notification bell. Walt Disney. In the 1920s, Walt Disney made Disney. Since then, Disney's gone on to make some of the best kids' movies of all time. They also have kids' theme parks and things every kid loved in their childhood. But most people don't know that Walt Disney had a dark past. It's said that Walt Disney did not like Jewish people very much at all. He was also a founding member of the Motion Picture Alliance. This group allegedly had many privately anti-Semitic members. In 2014, actress Meryl Streep even said that he was an anti-Semite and misogynist. This claim was even backed up by Walt's grandniece, Abigail Disney. Also, some of his movies, for example Song of the South, have been criticized by the NAACP. That is for perpetuating African-American stereotypes. It's kind of crazy to look back at someone who made such great childhood films in this light. But what do you think? Does this ruin Disney for you or not? Mr. Mosby. If you're a 90s kid, I'm sure you remember The Suite Life of Zack and Cody. And then the later series, The Suite Life on Deck. Many say that their favorite character in these shows was Mr. Mosby. Marion Mosby, better known as Mr. Mosby, was portrayed by Phil Lewis. But before the show aired, the actor Phil Lewis had a pretty dark past. In December of 1991, he was arrested after striking Isabel Duarte with his car. This caused Isabel of Bethesda, Maryland to pass away. He was charged with manslaughter and driving while intoxicated. His blood alcohol level was 3 times the legal limit. A court sentenced him to 5 years in prison, but he only served one. Instead, he began working with a prison-based theater group. He performed in jails, schools, and churches to highlight the consequences of alcohol abuse. Of course, he's now moved on and is a successful actor, but I'm pretty sure no kids watching his TV shows realized his dark past. Frankly, I'm surprised his sentence was so lenient, considering that Isabel passed away due to his driving. Cowardly Lion. We all remember the movie and story of The Wizard of Oz, and one of the main characters in it is the Cowardly Lion. But did you know that the lion costume in The Wizard of Oz is made of real lion hair? That's right, a lion had to be hunted down and taken out to get this costume. That kind of makes the whole thing pretty creepy. The actor was literally dressed in a deceased lion to play a lion. Recently, the costume was sold for more than $3 million at an auction in New York City. But it attracted a lot of controversy because it is a real lion. The costume, worn by actor Bert Lehr, weighed over 100 pounds. Lions are now an endangered species around the world. So does this fact ruin The Wizard of Oz for you or not? Elmo. I'm pretty sure every kid watched Sesame Street growing up. We loved all of the characters, especially the main character, Elmo. But many don't know the man behind Elmo. That is a puppeteer and actor named Kevin Clash. He performed and voiced Elmo from 1985 to 2012. But why did he stop in 2012? Well, in November of 2012, a man named Sheldon Stevens alleged something against Kevin. He said that while he was underage, him and Kevin had an inappropriate relationship. Kevin acknowledged this and said it was between consenting adults. But 2 weeks later, another accuser came forward to talk about Kevin. That is someone named Cecil Singleton. Kevin then resigned from Sesame Street, and 3 claims were brought against him in court. In 2013, these claims were all dismissed by the court. That's because they were way past the statute of limitations. Do you guys believe Kevin, or do you believe the accusers? And does this change the way you see the character of Elmo? I feel bad for Kevin if he did nothing wrong. But if he did do these things, then he gets no sympathy from me. Peter Pan. We all know and love the story of Peter Pan. But when you think about it, a boy who never grows up is kind of a strange premise. Where did it come from? Well, we can look to the character's creator, J.M. Barrie. J.M. Barrie has actually revealed the origin of the Peter Pan character. And it's something that recent makers of Peter Pan movies have tried to cover up. Peter Pan is actually based off of J.M. Barrie's 13-year-old brother. He cracked his skull and passed away while ice skating. And that's why J.M. Barrie wrote about a boy who never grows old. This makes the whole character a lot more creepy. That's right, the reason why Peter Pan can't grow older is because he's not alive. Blue Ranger. As a kid, I'm sure you watched the Power Rangers. But do you know who's behind those helmets and colorful suits? Well, one of those people was David Yost. He played the character of Billy, the Blue Ranger in Power Rangers. Sadly, he left his role, but why? Well, he said it's because he was actually bullied by the crew members and cast. That is because he was gay. Later, this bullying even caused him to go to conversion therapy because he was so sad. He said, "I put myself through conversion therapy because I didn't want to be gay. I really struggled with it. I sort of had to start the process of learning to accept myself, which was very difficult. It took me many years after the fact." So it's pretty sad to learn that these terrible things were going on the set of Power Rangers. It seemed all happy to us as kids, but behind the camera, that's not what was taking place. We never knew these seemingly heroic and powerful characters were bullying and getting bullied on the set. Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss is one of the greatest children's authors to ever live, but many don't know about his dark side. Researchers now say Dr. Seuss may have been prejudiced against African Americans and Asian Americans. They criticize the drawings of a Chinese man in the story and to think I saw it on Mulberry Street. In the book If I Ran a Zoo, a man also says he would put a person of color wearing a turban on display. But if you don't think that's bad, then you should really hear about Dr. Seuss's wife. Dr. Seuss actually cheated on his wife, Helen Palmer, and he did this while she was sick with cancer. As a result of this, Helen took her own life. She did this by taking too many pills. Her final note read, "I'm too old and enmeshed in everything you do and are." She said, "I cannot conceive of life without you. My going will leave quite a rumor. But you can say I was overworked and overwrought. Your reputation with your friends and fans will not be harmed." So even though she took her own life, she still did not want to expose what Dr. Seuss had done. Red Ranger. We've already covered how the Blue Ranger was bullied for being gay on set. But he isn't the only Power Ranger who will ruin your childhood. Ricardo Mendia played the Red Ranger. And in 2015, he was arrested after taking the life of his roommate Joshua Sutter. This was after Ricardo used a Conan the Barbarian medieval sword on him. That's right, he literally took his own roommate's life with a medieval sword. It's said this happened because of an argument over Ricardo's girlfriend. In 2017, Ricardo pled guilty to one count of voluntary manslaughter, and later that year he was sentenced to 6 years in prison. This changes the way I'll see Red Ranger forever. Ferris Bueller. Every kid, and frankly adult, loves the film Ferris Bueller's Day Off. It stars Matthew Broderick, and he's also been in many other great films. But did he know about his dark past? In 1987, he was driving in Northern Ireland. That was when he crossed into the wrong lane. He then collided head-on with a 28-year-old woman named Anna Gallagher and her mother. Both of them were taken out instantly. Matthew also fractured his leg and ribs in the crash. He was charged with taking a life by dangerous driving. He was facing up to 5 years in prison, but instead got off with a $100 fine. The victim's son and brother called it a travesty of justice. Lion King. Everyone knows and loves the Lion King movie. And I'm pretty sure as kids, our favorite character was Simba. This movie was released in 1994, and the average lifespan of a lion is 15 years. This means if Simba from The Lion King was real, he probably would have passed away back in 2009. And now in 2020, he would almost definitely not be alive. It's pretty sad to think that in real terms, our favorite kids movie characters would no longer be alive. But thankfully, they're kept alive forever on the silver screen, even if they do have some pretty dark backstories. Let me know in the comments, have any of these facts ruined any TV show, book, or movie for you? If they did, then I'm sorry for ruining your childhood memories. Personally, I think the thing that makes me the most surprised is what Mr. Mosby did. Of course, the actor Phil Lewis did not mean to do that, so we can't blame him too much. But he still was driving while under the influence. And of course, he has now turned his life around and is beloved. But it's still a pretty dark backstory not many people know about this very popular actor. But now it's time for you to make your voice heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner for the fact that ruined your childhood most. If you want some more amazing videos, then subscribe to my second channel. But as always, thank you for watching. There's some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.